Hello, I'm Clemens from exocad. Welcome to the second part of our bar series. This tutorial features a step-by-step Dolder and Hader bar design, including a deep dive in bar profile parameters. To achieve the workflow we show in this video, bar and implant module are required. If you haven't watched the beginning of our series, I would recommend to do so before continuing with this part. Feel free to use the table of content to jump directly to the part of your choice. Because we are using the same setup in our previous tutorial already, let's fast forward to bar profile parameters right away. The standard male part of a Dolder is available in two dimensions, the macro and a smaller micro version in case the necessary space isn't available. Also, a resilient variation is available in both sizes if you modify the profile DY. The difference is to be found in the lower part of the profile, where a slight rotation and retention of the prefabricated female clip attachment is provided. Alternatively, there are also several variants from our partners available, providing you with the corresponding female part. Quite similar in functionality compared with the resilient Dolder, but different in design, is the Hader bar that you can see here. It is available under the profile name Keyhole. Let's deep dive into the bar profile parameters by extending the menu, explaining them in detail. However, predefined parameters should be used in general and modifications coordinated with a milling partner. The radius of 1.1 mm is creating the circular arch on top of the male bar and result in the required diameter of 2.2 mm. What is exactly the width we can't fall below? The parameter X shape affects the top curve from round to parabolic. There are multiple ways to add material to the bottom. For example, if the height is set to 4 mm and the minimum height to 3. The minimum height is a visualizer which is used to check if the minimum height is respected everywhere, like you can see here. In addition, this visualizer also secures that there is enough space for the female part available. If the variable bottom or variable sides checkbox is activated, you can add material with ease in that direction. The last both parameters allow you to add a bottom step easily. And some profiles have specific parameters as well, where you can add also an angle on the lingual or buckle side. Maybe you notice the different colors these profiles have, or that they change the initially displayed color after you checked or unchecked variable sides and bottom. This is showing on first sight that green profiles allow you to change variable sides and bottom, blue profiles only have a variable bottom, on red profiles only variable sides are available, and dark red profiles do not allow any changes here at all, because they are all limited due to their specific geometry. Note, for all the bars shown in this video, we strongly recommend switching off variable sides to keep the exact dimensions for perfect results. The variable bottom you can use without hesitation. Last but not least, you can save changes you made for further projects and import own designs with these two buttons. If you'd like to continue our deep dive, the question mark icon will lead you to our Wiki page. Here, you can find plenty of valuable information, including the hotkeys we used. Now let's start with the design of our standard macro Dolder. You may find it helpful to display the anatomical parts by pressing E, or display the pre-op model with P to place the control points as ideal as possible. Also, we check that the available space will be enough for the female parts we want to implement by checking the display distance, and make sure to deselect variable sides to keep the exact dimensions for a perfect fit. Now, we set the insertion axis manually by dragging the green arrow. Alternatively, we could set it from view. Either way, we'll create a plane orthogonal to the insertion direction, and we can take advantage of this by clicking on the light blue arrow. Now the segment you're pointing at will move orthogonally to the insertion direction, which is indicated by a dark blue arrow. A further click on it will release the parallel guidance of this segment. The last control point we selected is shown in yellow. This allows us to apply changes to specific selection only, offering the opportunity to add horizontally clip-on attachments to any bar design. If we reapply the keyhole profile everywhere, the whole bar design will change. This how we can change easily to the resilient dollar bar by selecting the profile DY. Let us finish this tutorial by designing a standard dollar profile with extensions. Sometimes it's necessary that the length of a bar exceeds the pillar limit. Our software helps to minimize the use of leverage. As you can see, the distance and direction of the retaining elements will affect the displayed recommended span. Let us modify the pillar slightly and switch from a sharp to round edges in the advanced tab. Finally, we can pull down the bar if the variable button is activated. To move a group of points, press Shift to move one neighboring point, Control to move even two neighboring points on each side, and by holding Control and Shift together, you move all the points at once. By default, the bottom of our bar will be cropped to the gingiva. In our next tutorial, we will cover all our advanced options in detail. So let's proceed with next to the freeforming step that we already explained in our previous tutorial. With one final click on Next, our bar is ready for manufacturing. That was the second part of our bar series. Please check out our Wiki page by clicking on any question mark icon in our software. Thank you for listening and see you soon. If you'd like to learn more, our resellers are always happy to help. And in case you are looking for one-to-one training from one of our exocad experts, visit our webshop shop.exocad.com and book your personalized training online. Select from a variety of topics like DentalCAD or exoplan core basics, release highlight introductions, module how-tos, question and answer sessions, system checkups, and more. Our technical help desk specialist will be happy to answer all your questions and provide you with a certificate and recording to make your learning experience as beneficial as possible for you.